96, 97, 98, 99, 100. Yeah, that's how we do it with our brand new beard comb that we're making on today's episode.
Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop, sponsored by
Microjig, maker of the Gripper. Work safer, work smarter.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. On today's episode, we are making this fun little beard comb. Now, it happens to be that this is something that I'm making just for my scrap pile. I got a nice hickory handle on here and a, not really sure what it is for the blade itself. It is part of those scraps and cutoffs that I picked up from the folks over at Bell Forest. They just put together a box of, like, you know, 25 pounds worth of cutoffs, and you order it and they send it out to you, and it's a neat opportunity to maybe play with some woods that you ordinarily wouldn't get a chance to. But regardless, it worked out perfectly for our project here. Now, another reason why I chose to make a beard comb is because as we're recording this, it's the beginning of November, and many of you might even refer to it as Movember or No Shave November. And the reason why you refer to it as Movember or No Shave November is because of the fact that you oftentimes, maybe you're very clean-shaven folks, you're shaving your face every day, you don't really like to have any facial hair going on there, but during November, you'll go ahead and grow out that mustache or that beard because you want to bring awareness to research for prostate cancer, testicular cancer, and even some mental health issues. So it's a really great cause to get behind. I know I've had some fun with it, going to some of the parties and doing some of the fundraising stuff. So keep your eye out for information about that. In fact, I'll have a link in the show notes where you can find more information about organizations and maybe even activities going on around you so that you can have a really great reason to try and catch up with me. I mean, this is gorgeous. It took me a long time to get there, but I am so happy with it. Anyways, let's move into the construction of the beard comb itself. Really, when it comes down to it, again, it's just the two pieces of wood. It doesn't have to be contrasting. It can be all one species. It could have been all hickory or something. And the main way we put it together is we're just using a basic bridle joint to bring the whole entire comb together. Now, the design is based off of a smaller comb that I had a long time ago, and you'll see it actually in part of the video today. But I just wanted to have something a little bit thicker, a little bit easier to hold on to, and this was definitely a lot of fun. So let's jump right into the joinery, let's jump right into the construction, and you'll see a nice mix of power tools and hand tools, and then we'll talk about it on the backside. To cut the groove for the bridle joint in the handle, I start by extending the saw blade as high as it'll go, which actually works out near perfectly for the dimension of the comb blade. I then clamp the handle stock to a backer board and carefully feed it into the blade to establish the first shoulder of the joint. We'll repeat the same action again, but this time it's to cut the comb blade itself. Now, to ensure the bridle joint on the handle matches the thickness of the comb blade, I'll do a little relative dimensioning to determine how wide a cut I need to make by using the blade itself as my template. Now, with the pencil mark as my guide, I then adjust my marking gauge as needed and scratch the line. Then it's back over to the table saw where I slide the rip fence over to match the mark and then remove the material. Now that all those initial cuts are made, I then lower the table saw blade and I cut the comb blade free. And yes, I know I'm cutting on the side of the blade where it could shoot back at me, but that's kind of why I'm standing a little more to the left than usual. Now once the comb blade was cut free, I need to clean up the surface just slightly to remove blade marks. I'll do this on my bench hook with a hand plane and then eventually with a card scraper to help even everything out. The result is a nice fit that's not too tight and it's not too loose. So this gives me a chance to add enough glue to both sides, which I just smear on using my finger. Once the comb blade is positioned where I want it, I then add a couple of clamps and I set it aside to dry. So after letting the glue dry overnight, the next evening I remove the clamps and I plane the top of the comb blade flush with the handle. With that done, it's time to shape the comb, which I could do this freehand, but I have a smaller comb I've been using for a few years that I like the shape of, so I'll use it as a template for the curves of this larger version. And here's the result of blending all of those curves together. So now it's over to the bandsaw to start cutting all those curves. Another option, of course, is to use, say, a coping or a fret saw, but unfortunately I don't have a decent blade for mine, so I guess I'll just suffer through with my bandsaw instead. Now when it's all done, the shape and feel is very close to what I want in my hand. Now it's time to start refining those curves, and then this time I'm going to turn to my spokeshave to help me get started. I'm no expert on spokeshaves whatsoever, but I love that you can push or pull them to get the job done, and also that they can give you a lot of control in tricky grain situations. So as I mentioned, again, I am not an expert on spokeshaves, so it's no surprise when I started to get some tear out on the back side of the handle and I was having trouble figuring out which way to hold the spokeshave. So instead, what I ended up doing was I eventually grabbed my rasp and decided to work the shapes with those instead. This was an especially helpful way to help refine this part of the handle on the underside. Then, to blend it all together and leave a silky smooth surface, I just grabbed some sandpaper and I worked those edges. So now it's time to cut the teeth on the comb blade, and I start by marking the waste that I want removed. Then, using a sacrificial fence on my table saw's miter gauge, I clamp the comb in position, eyeball that first cut with the slot on the fence, and make the cut. Then it's a matter of unclamping, moving the blade over slightly, and making the next series of cuts. If I were to do this again, you know, I probably will set up more of a repeatable jig for this process, something very similar to what you would use with a box joint or a finger joint. So the final steps are slightly chamfering the ends of the teeth, a task which is easily accomplished with a chisel. And then it's a matter of easing all of the edges, which I just do with some sandpaper and a little bit of patience. All right, folks, well, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. This was a fun little project, and like I said at the beginning, it's a project hopefully to kind of bring awareness to the whole Movember, No Shave November cause. And like I said, I'll have links in the show notes to help you find more information about it. One thing I will say regarding the design is, originally, I had made both the comb and the blade the same exact thickness, which is about 3/4 inch. And then I just simply kind of angled where the teeth were. It turns out that you need to have a little bit of a thinner blade for it to really get in there and be able to work and not catch and yank those beard hairs out. Another thing, obviously, is that tooth configuration. It looks a little wonky, but this wider tooth configuration, the space right in between them, works out perfectly. So if anything, maybe just a little bit more of a gap, but otherwise it works fantastic. So there's a whole bunch of other things we can do with the overall shape and size and of the teeth themselves, but what I have right here seems to work pretty good. That blade comes in about 1/4 inch is what we have it right now. So anyways, when it comes to the finish, one thing I will recommend, I'll probably end up putting like a shellac or just a basic penetrating oil on the handle. And when it comes to the blade, you want to be kind of careful about this one because obviously, depending on who you're giving it to, there are plenty of oils that you could potentially have an allergic reaction to. I happen to use a number of beard oils that my wife has purchased for me because she likes the smell of them, and I like the fact that she likes to smell my beard while we're sitting on the couch together and stuff. So anyways, I have actually gone through so far and applied those oils directly to the blade and then used those to work into the beard. So not only does my beard come out smelling nice, but it turns out those oils are doing a really great job of putting a finish on the blade itself. And so it looks really good, it smells great, and it works fantastic. If you have comments, questions, suggestions, I would love to hear from all of you. You can contact me at mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. Of course, you can stop by the website at mattsbasementworkshop.com and leave a comment over there. Or if you're watching this over at YouTube, you can leave a comment there. Like I said, I love hearing from all of you. And coming up soon, we have another project that is kind of male facial hair oriented. We'll get more into that towards the end of November when it's time for that to come out, but hopefully it'll be something that you'll really, really enjoy. And in the meantime, if you happen to make a beard comb, or if you have a different style of beard comb that you make, I would love to see pictures of that. Please, you can post those over at our Facebook page, or you can even send those to me and I will try to get them up on the website so that we can all see the amazing things that you're creating. So until then, straight grains and sharp blades. Take care, everybody.
Thanks for watching. For more information on topics discussed in this episode, visit madsbasementworkshop.com. Also, please consider becoming a patron of Mads Basement Workshop. Get early access to new shows, bonus content from each episode, and so much more. Visit patreon.com/madsbasementworkshop to sign up and start receiving your benefits today.